show you very specifically how to drift from God. Neglect your time with God. Do not enroll in a YouVersion Bible plan. Do not let your friends come along and support you, because the Word of God is living and active and sharper than any double-edged sword. It washes your mind and makes you new. It speaks to you. It encourages you. It builds your faith and gives you strength. So by all means, neglect the Word of God. Come in late if you have to. Sit on the back. Don't pay attention. Just fake that you're still close to Jesus. And that is a guarantee way to make it not work. Now, that was really hard to be sarcastic for that long in the middle of a message. But I hope you'll see some effectiveness in what I just did. And the reason why I was so insistent on trying to make this point is not because I'm coming down on anybody else, but because this was a real issue in my life at a very significant point in my development as a pastor. I ended up playing a role more than I was pursuing Christ. And I'm not proud to tell you this, but I played the role. Back then, when I studied the Bible, it was more in order to preach than it was in order to feed on the living word that would transform my heart. When you look at it, if there was a time before that you were closer to Jesus than you are today, what happened? We need to recognize that he didn't move, that we actually drifted away. If you're feeling that's a good thing, meaning, oh, this is speaking to me, I'm recognizing this is really me. Okay, if that's happening to you, let me just tell you, that's a good thing. It's a good thing. Why? Because your heart's good soil. That means that as the word is going out, the Holy Spirit is speaking to you. Okay, don't worry if that's you being encouraged. If, on the other hand, you know you've drifted from God, and you're hearing this, and you're thinking, don't really like this one. Wish he's talking about something else. If you know you've drifted from God, and that's your attitude, that's when you really need to be cautious, be aware, pay attention, because your heart, the soil, might be rocky ground or thorny. And what we want to do is go before God and say, make it good. Make it good. Make it good.